To what extent are India's different religions integrated with each other?
Again, a good question. Again, you see, I'm blowing my own trumpet because I can't help it. For thousands of years, this nation has allowed people of other religions to come and live with them. They don't impose any penalty, special tax because you're not non-Hindu. They don't enforce themselves on them, saying you must convert, otherwise you can't stay in my country. They don't infringe on their own practices. So thousands of, you know, so many millions of people have entered India from other religions, other traditions, other cultures, and they're allowed to live in with us without any imposition. No other nation would do this. In fact, I told you at the question time, if I had come to Eton College 300 years ago and talk about pluralism, many ways to be spiritual, they said, Mr. Lakhan, you must be a witch, we'll burn you. They would have burned me here at Eton. But thousands of years ago, the first ancient Christian Syrians who were persecuted in Syria, this is not a new thing, they found a home in India, they stayed in India, even now, after 1,000 years. The Jews who were perhaps, you know, left, you know, Jerusalem because of the temple was destroyed, many of them found a home in India. Yahudis, they live in India happily and practice their religion, no imposition. The Zoroastrians, the whole religion would have disappeared if India had not stepped in. They entered Gujarat, Surat, and then they established themselves there. That's the Tata business, Tata family. They came to India and merged with us, integrated with us so well, we can't distinguish them. The Parsis, the Zoroastrians, we feel they are like us. We feel tremendous, you know, comfort, you know, tremendous affinity for them. And they feel for us. Tata is contributing 70% of the profits for the philanthropic work in India. I love these people.